Families across the country set to gather today for the holiday weekend. Before they headed out for the holiday, John Berman and Harry Enten broke down the data on the celebration of Christmas. Take a look.
It is Christmas Eve, and many Americans are preparing to celebrate Christmas, whether it's wrapping last-minute gifts or trimming a tree or taking out their favorite movie. Here to run through what Americans say they're doing is senior data reporter Harry Enten.
I'm feeling the season.
You're looking the season.
I'm looking the season, and you know why I'm looking the season? Because it's Christmas season. And you know what? It's probably one of the holidays that most Americans celebrate. Look at this. Do you celebrate Christmas? 92% of all Americans do. 96% of Christians. Even 81% of non-Christians celebrate it. It's pretty much now, you know, it's a religious holiday, but it's also a secular holiday. Pretty much most businesses are closed at this point, except for maybe the local Jewish deli and the Chinese food shop.
Harry Enten, I have to tell you, of all the statistics that you've ever shown me, this next one is the most surprising to me, and it has to do about Christmas trees.
It has to do about Christmas trees. Okay, do you have a Christmas tree in your home? 22% say no, ergo me. But look at this, 55% say yes, but it is artificial. It is artificial. Just 22% say yes, and it's real.
I've always been in the Northeast. This is shocking to me, but I guess a lot of the country, you don't have the opportunity to get a real
Christmas tree. You're one of those Northeastern coastal elitists, I would
say. Yeah, he has the real tree. All right, favorite Christmas movie?
Yeah, you know, Die Hard's not on here. So.
Well, that's the crime. I mean, that's the thing here. This is just wrong. These stats are wrong.
These stats are apparently wrong. Elf at 6%. I didn't realize Elf was that popular. It's a Wonderful Life. Look, that's a classic at 9%. A Christmas Story is 7%. I mean, you can't go anywhere without watching it, right? It's on pretty much all day. Even, look at this. I think a lot of people would agree with this. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. You know, perhaps I'll be like Clark Griswold and get up there and, you know, actually put up the decorations.
Unpopular opinion. A Christmas Story is actually kind of sad. I always look at it. I don't really laugh. I think it's kind of sad. Anyway, holiday, there's a lot of stress around
holidays. There's a lot of stress around holidays. What causes the most amount of stress? Maybe this segment for me. No, I'm just kidding. Look at this. Finding the right gifts at 28%. Traveling 24%. Getting from one place to another, especially if you're in Home Alone or Home Alone 2. That really does seem to cause a lot of stress. Being with family, 17%. Nothing. No stress. Good for you, folks. 16%. Cooking, I don't know how to do that. 9%. Just go to the Chinese restaurant.
When are people done with their shopping?
Look, if you're still shopping up to this minute, you got a lot of people in your company. Look at that. In the last 10 days before Christmas, 36%. Oh, good for you. That 32% done by December 15th. 22% done by December 1st. My God, you folks are really amazing. No holiday shopping again because I'm cheap. 7%. I probably fall into that.
Harry, what do you want for the holidays?
What do I want for the holidays? Look at this. My Bills are playing your Patriots. Yeah. It's a rematch. All I need is a win. Just one, please. I'm begging, please.
You know your problem? Bill Belichick's the Grinch. If there's one guy who's the Grinch, it's Bill Belichick before his heart grows.
With his real Christmas tree in New England.
You got it. Harry Enten, happy holidays to you.
Happy holidays to you, my friend.
The dynamic duo right there. So, Jim, real tree, fake tree. What do you got?
Oh, definitely real tree.
Same.
I don't do the fake tree. I cut it down myself, actually.
Oh, I love that. We did that growing up. Now I'm lazy.
Yeah, but I did it in your yard, Erica. I'm sorry.
That explains the missing tree. Also, favorite movie. I think Daddy's Home 2 was missing from that list.
No, it's got to be It's a Wonderful Life. There's nothing that contends with that. It's the best Christmas movie ever.
All right. I don't know. How about Miracle on 34th Street, the black and white version?
Good, too.
Yeah. All right. We'll continue this discussion in the break.